Hello students, how are you? Hope everyone is well. So now today we will discuss next exercise. So our syllabus is almost finished. In a previous video I told you that our syllabus is finished. Now from in a previous video onwards we will discuss only the questions and answers. Okay, now today we will discuss the C++, that is C programming, second lesson questions. Page number, you can see the page number, only the tough questions. Okay, the easy questions you will do yourselves. Okay, see, if you not understand any questions, just call me or WhatsApp me. Okay, I will solve any questions. Okay, but now I will discuss some important and very tricky questions with hard questions, you can say. So page number 295, question number K, page number 295, you can see, and question number is K. This is question number K. Okay, now you can see here, check and correct the following C program. Check and correct the following C program. The question is, has it truth? That is stdio.is. And after that, main function, int main, next, int a equal to 23, curly braces, int a equal to 23, okay, next, float b equal to 5.43, okay, next, printf, that is percentage d percentage f and percentage again d. Okay, now after that comma a comma b comma, that is 125. Okay, now after that curly bracket close. Okay, now you can see this equation. Okay, now here the question is, check and correct the syntax of the following equations. So first of all, you see the questions. Where is the syntax error? Syntax error means the coding error. When you write the code, syntax means code. Okay, syntax means code. When you write the code, at a time, sometimes we fall. Sometimes we are means write wrong keywords or wrong inputs. Okay, so at a times our compiler will give some errors. So here there are some mistakes is happen. So you just find out the mistakes. Where is the mistakes? You can find it. Can you find it? First of all, see, this is the header file. Okay, main function curly bracket int a is 23. Int means integer and a is a variable. This 23 is okay. Float means fractional, decimal. B equal to 5.43. It's okay. Printf, d means, that is a equal to what? It is an integer, so that's why d is required. Okay, float, so that's why f required. Again, in the d parts, 125 is a what? Integer, so that's why d is coming. But where is the mistake? The mistake is in the last part. You can see there is no return 0. You have to give return 0. You must give a statement, it is return 0. So this is the mistake, or this is the syntax error. So when you not give a return 0, it will not give the output. Okay, the questions, the coding is correct, but return 0 means what? The program, the main function is ended here. Return 0 means the program ended correctly. And also it means that whatever we expect from the program, we got it from the output. Whatever we expect from the program, we got from the output. Whatever the output will produce from the program, it will give the correct output. So that's why return 0 is very much important in any C or C++ program. And return 0 also means that the program is end here. Okay, so this is the correct syntax of this program. Okay, hope you understand this question. So now we'll go to the next question. Next question, that is I, question number I. You can see again, check character syntax and following C programs. Okay, again, there is a syntax error, you have to correct it. Okay, now see, first I have to write the question as include stdio.is. This is the header file. Okay, next is main function. Start the main function, int main, curly bracket start, int ab. I'm taking two variables a and b, so that's why this is an integer variable. A and b both are variable, this is an integer variable. Next is printf, enter two numbers. Okay, I'm giving a message to the user that enter two value. Okay, enter two value or enter two numbers. Okay, enter two numbers. Okay, now you can see after that what happens. Scanf means what? Scanf is a function which is used to take the input from the user. Scanf is %d, again %d, comma a comma b. Okay, a comma b. Okay, now next is, you can see printf, again printf, here I am using printf, the message is you entered %d, comma a comma b. Okay, now last one is return 0. Okay, this is the question. This is the exact question. Okay, now you find out the error from the program. So where is the mistakes in the program? Now you can see there is a new thing in this program, scanf. Scanf means what? In the book you can see what is the meaning of scanf. Okay, you can see in the page number 287, scanf means the scanf function is used to accept the input data from the user through the keywords. Means scanf is a function which is used to accept the input data from the keyboard. Okay, now
The general format of scanf is, you can see here, scanf, control string, and person variable, and person variables. Now see, there is a one option is required. The and person symbol before the variable name in an operator, the specific address of the variable where the data is to be stored.
Okay. Now see, in the scanf, before variable, we need a symbol. This symbol is and person. We need this symbol. We need this symbol and person. This and person means what? Address of. Means address of. Okay. First, we have to know in this program very carefully. You can see. First, I am taking two variables A and B. Okay. A and B, they are two variables. Okay. This is A, this is B. Okay. Now here there is a message is given, enter two numbers. So I am request to the users that enter two numbers. The users enter two numbers. One is 10, one is 20. So this scanf actually used to take the input from the keyboard. Okay. Now after that, where is 10 stored and where is 10, 20 will be stored? This will be decided by the this symbol, address of symbol. So that's why here the mistakes. There is no and person symbol here. So that's why we need this symbol. And person A, comma, and person B. This means that 10 is in the address A and 20 is in the address B. Okay, so this is the required when you use the scanf functions. Okay, so that is the mistakes in the program. After that, again you enter the output will be coming in this way. The output will be in this way. We entered 10, 20. Okay, so this is the actually the actual program. You need this and person means address of symbol. Okay, so this is the actual program and here the mistakes. Okay, hope you understand this question. Okay, so we'll go to the next question. If you have any problem, again I say, if you have any problems, please ask me. Next question. You can see question number, page number 296. Page number 296. 296. Okay. In this page number, you can see question number 3. Question number 3. That what will be the value of the C after the execution of the following code? Assume that A, B, C are declared as int data type. Okay. I am writing the question A equal to 20, B equal to what? 6. Okay. C equal to A plus B. C equal to A plus B and lastly C equal to C into 5. And here you can see it assumes that A, B and C are declared as int data type. So that's why first we have to declare the answer is first we have to declare A, B, C as an integer, int A, B, C. Okay, after that again you write B equal to A equal to 20 and B equal to 6. Okay, C equal to A plus B and C equal to C into 5. Okay, I'm assuming the in A, B, C is an inter variable. Okay, now I can see here there are three variables, 1, 2, and this is the third variable, which is A, B, and C. A equal to 20, B equal to 6. Here C equal to A plus B. A plus B equal to C means 20 plus 6 equal to half, 26. Okay, now C equal to, now C equal to 26. Okay, now after that again C equal to C into 5 means C into 5 equal to C. Means what? C equal to, that is C value what? 26 into 5. How much? That is C equal to 130. Okay, 130. Okay, so C equal now 130. So the answer will be, so the answer here, the answer need to declare the value of C will be, the answer is, the output is equal to 30. Okay, so this is the actual answer, this is the explanation. Okay, this is the explanation. I'm just explain the question, nothing explained. Okay, now the output will be 30. Okay, so in this way you can easily get the outputs. Okay, first go to the, see how much value in A or B. After that C equal to A plus B, then after that C equal to C into 5, that is 130. That is C equal to 130. Okay. Next question. Next question is number 4. For you can see here, write a statement to read the 3 integer numbers entered by the user. Such as 34, 123, 435. Use the variable. Okay. Now you can see, write a statement. Just write the statement. Just write the statement. Write the statement only. Statement means what? A single statement, not whole the program. Okay, just remember these things. Not whole program, only just the statement you require. Write the statement to read the 3 integers. So read means what? Take the input from the user with the help of keyboard. So this is with the help of scanf. Very good. So we have to write the statement scanf. What? Everything is easy. Just you go to the chapter very carefully and it will be very easy. All the questions are very easy. The answer is scanf. Scanf. Next, what happened? Next, we have to write what? We have to write this things very carefully. Scanf, and after that first you have to assume them. Here you can see the question is, you can see numbers are what? All our numbers are 34, 123, 435. Numbers is, first you have to know the numbers 34, wait one thing. First, I have to write the numbers 34, next 123, and next is 435. So these are what? These are actually what? These are actually integer. These are actually integer types. Because why? They say whole numbers, not fraction numbers. If it is a fraction numbers, then it will be a floating type data type. But it is an integer data type.
Okay, now the output, the answer will be in this way. You can see, I have to write the answers.
Solution. For examples, I'm just taking the variable in A, B, and C. These three numbers. A equal to 34, B equal to 123, and C equal to 435. Okay, scanf. Again, %d. This means what? D means the, if the data is an integer, then we have to give D. If it is a float, then you have to give DAF. If it is a character, you have to give C. Okay, now see, after that, comma, and you have to again give the what? N person A, N person B, and N person C. This is the exact question and the answers. Okay, so this is the answers. I think you understand. First, we have to remember this is an integer data type because whole numbers. So that's why I am taking three variables in A, B, and C. After that, A equal to 34, B equal to 123, B equal to 123, and C equal to 435. And after that, I am taking the scanf function. Scanf function is used to what? It is used to take the input from the user. So you can see, it will also read the data from the users through keywords. So that's why scanf, %d, 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 comma, n person. So n person means what? Again I say n person means address of. Okay. So in this way you can get the answers. So I think you understand this questions answers. Okay. So I'll go to the next question, the last question. Question number 5. How many bytes will require in the memory? How many bytes is required in the memory? How many bytes require in the memory? Okay. First, you have to know 8 bit equal to 1 byte. 8 bit equal to 1 byte. Okay. Now you can see the examples is given here. This single quotation marks. It means what? When you give any single quotation mark in a character data types, it is a what? It is a character. Okay, and second one is B is double quotation. Double quotation means what? It is a string data type. It is a character data type. It is a string data type. So character will take only 1 byte, and string will take 4 bytes. So the answer will be in this way. Okay, now see. In your exams, it may come how many bits is equal to 1 byte. That is 8 bits equal to 1 byte. Okay. Now the answer would be in this way. So see how many bytes are required in the memory? X. Why? X is a character because here only single quotation mark. Single quotation mark means what? It is a character constant or it is a character index. Next, double quotation marks means what? It is a string. Strings require 4 bytes and character require only 1 byte. Okay, so I think you understand today's discussions, that is the question and answers. Okay, next question, next video, next online class, I will also discuss the question and answers. So, I request everybody that please join our doubting sessions, because if you have any problem, if you face any problem, please ask me in our doubting sessions. And also, I request everyone that please watch this online classes. It's so important because it's it may come in your exams. So this type of question is so important. Okay, so hope you understand today's class. If you have any problems, please ask me. Okay, thank you everybody for watching this video. Again I say, stay at home and be safe. Thank you everybody, have a great day. Thank you.